Hi there, it's me again, your Lavanya. We are continuing our discussion, our thoughts on Unmai Vilakkam. Today, we are going ahead with the 39th verse. We have already been discussing about the five holy syllables, the mantra, which is Namasivaya or Sivaya Nama. Today's verse is actually relating to that itself. The verse goes this way. Nadanda Nadagatte Nandra Arul Seidir Odir Yurut Anjum Ullabadi Tidu Arave Anjurut Idahil Arium Yurutai Vidumo Tanja Arud Guruve Satru. Which means the first statement talks about Nadanda Nadagam, which means we have already seen 36 Tattuams. And out of these 36 tattvams, the topmost one is called as Nada Tattvam. Nadam is nothing but Shiva Tattvam. When we talk about Shiva Tattvam, that is basically the Nada Tattva, beyond that is where the omnipotent, omnipresent is there. So, when you talk about God, where is He? Is He within the 36 tattvam? No, He is beyond that. Is He within the mind or within our thought process or within our intellect? No, He is beyond that. So we have already seen He is beyond the Nada Tattva. So when you say beyond Nada Tattva, He is dancing as a cosmic dancer. And this was explained to us by the Guru. Now the disciple is going down to the Guru once again, asking one another very important question. The question is, Guru, you're talking about the holy mantra, the five syllables mantra, which is Namasivaya or Sivaya Nama. And we all know everything in this world is going to be demolished at one point in time. It is going back to Maya in one point in time. That's why we have been talking about ice ages. And even when we are talking about something in front of our eyes, someone was there yesterday, today they are not there. Today someone is there, tomorrow they are not going to be there. A tree was there, now it is not there. A house was there, it is not there. Tomorrow a new house is going to be built up. So when you look at it, whatever we are seeing around us is not permanent. It is going away, it is shedding away, it is totally fading away as well. So what happens to the five letter syllable? If you look at it, even the most oldest language, which is Tamil, 100 years back, whatever words we have been using, we are not using it today. 1,000 years back, whatever words we were using, we are not using it today. 5,000 years back, whatever words we were using, we are not using it today. So words, letters also goes through an evolution. When you talk about transformation and evolution, that is inevitable. So does it mean the five letter syllable is also going to be demolished at one particular stage? So the question that is put forth to the Guru is very simple. Guru, I want a clarification in terms of the five syllables. The mantra, is it also going to be faded away or evaded in one point in time? Can you please clarify my question? This is the beautiful question that is put forth. And there is one very nice phrase that is being used in this particular verse, which is saying, Tanja Arud Guru, literally translated as the Guru, who is the right person for me to go and surrender myself totally. This is something which is a very important concept, because we all know if you want to move ahead in our spiritual life, we must get a guru. Now the problem is we know that we need to have a guru, but I'm not having a guru. So what I'll start doing is I'll start looking out for gurus around me. If someone is calling someone as a guru, I may be fascinated by that and I just go and fall a prey for that, which is happening right now around us, and we are able to see that. So, does it mean that they are going to be a guru? Just evaluate for yourself. Is the guru showing you the path of realization, or they are asking you for more money, richness, or they are looking at growing their own ashrams. If you look at asking money to grow their own ashrams, evaluating that this situation is important because they are not showing what they are supposed to show to us. They are supposed to show, who am I? They are supposed to show, who is God? But instead, what are they doing? They are asking us to work hard for building up their ashram, which means they are asking us to move on and focus more on the materialistic things rather than the spiritual things. Evaluate. This is the best evaluator is you, your own self. If you really need a real guru, I would suggest this because most of us have done this, including me, and I'm talking from my experience on this. When I was longing to have a guru, what I simply did was went to a temple, and there is one particular idol called as Dakshinamurti. Dakshinamurti. Just go and sit in front of him. There is one particular padigam. Padigam is a combination of 10 songs together. From the 7th Thirumurai, 13th padigam, which is called as the place for which this was recited, is Thiruthurayur. Just keep reading that particular. Whether you understand the meaning, don't bother about it. Just sit in front of Lord Shiva in the form of Dakshinamurti, asking him for sending you a guru. A guru, real guru, will surely appear in front of you. This is something that we have been seeing and what we are enjoying right now. At least a couple of my friends have done that as well. So I'm talking from my experience, as I said. So searching for a guru should not happen at a physical level or a physiological level. It must not happen at an emotional level as well, but it must happen at a spiritual plane. In order to elevate us into the spiritual plane, that is where the Thirupadigams are going to help us. Watch the Thirupadigams, listen to it, start singing that. You will see immense pleasure in your life. You will see a total transformation in your life because all these are mantras. So, coming back to our verse, the concept, the underlying meaning of today's verse is, the disciple is going down to the guru asking to give a clarification on the 5-letter syllable mantra, which is Namasivaya or Sivaya Nama, asking if that will also be faded away once in this world. We will look at the answer very soon. Until then, bye-bye.